Let's say you have a multiple choice quiz created in MS Word, which is the normal practice. We have a question followed by multiple options, and the answer is right below the options. So you can select the answer and then change the font color to white, so you can take a printout and distribute to the class so they can answer the quiz. Now, what if you want to conduct the same quiz in a classroom using PowerPoint, where each question has its own slide? And once we are in the slide, we have the question in the title, and then each of the options is revealed on a click. And then once you get the answer from the student, you click on this button which says answer, and the right answer is revealed. Now, what if you could convert this Word file, which has multiple choice questions, into this PowerPoint file, which has custom animation to reveal options and even a trigger animation to reveal the answer? And you could do this conversion with just a few clicks. Would that be interesting? I'll show you how to do that in a step-by-step way in this video. Before that, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of PowerPoint Templates Pack for Teachers, a pack of more than 140 premium animated PowerPoint templates created exclusively for teachers. The link is in the description box below. The usual but inefficient way of converting this kind of an MCQ quiz from Word to PowerPoint is you select the title, then go to copy, then go back to PowerPoint, you right click and then paste for the question, and then come back again and select all the options, copy, and then go back to PowerPoint, and then you right click and paste all the options, and you will see this kind of an issue where the font sizes are not proper. Then you need to ensure that the font sizes are increased, and then you apply custom animation for each of the options. Don't even start me on how to get the trigger to reveal the answer. Now, if you need to do this for 25 questions, you will lose your patience, commit mistakes, and feel frustrated. Now let me show you an easy and efficient way to convert your MCQ quiz created in MS Word into an interactive animated PowerPoint quiz, even if you have 100 questions in your quiz. First, we need to format the word in a certain way so it's easy for us to make the conversion very quickly. The first thing is we need to ensure that the questions are given a different style. So I select the question and then give it heading 1. And then I go here and do this for each of the questions. Then we are going to select these options. You select just the first few options and then go here to the Home tab and go to Select and use this beautiful option called Select Text with Similar Formatting, and that would select all of these bullet points. Now, we don't want these answers to be selected, so I'm going to hold the control button and click on the answer, and that would deselect the answer. So I'm going to do that. Now we are going to change this into heading 2 style. Now the last bit that is left is for us to convert this into heading 3. So you select this and then go to Select and say Select Text with Similar Formatting. Can you see all these answers are selected in one go? Now you go to the style called Heading 3. Now that is also converted. Beautiful. Now the next step is to format all of this for fonts. So let me click here. That selects the title. Once again, go to Select and say Select Text with Similar Formatting, and all Heading 1 is selected. Then let us change this to the title format in our PowerPoint file. Let me choose 2cm empty condensed extra bold, or whichever font that you want to use in your PowerPoint file for the title. I'm going to change the font size to something really big, maybe around 36, and the title is formatted. The next step is to format the options. So let me select the first few options and then go to Select and say Select Text with Similar Formatting. All these H2 or Heading 2 are selected automatically. Now let me go to the font type and say Calibri, and then font size is 24. Now the options are selected and formatted. The next step is to format the answers. So let me select my first answer and then go to Select and say Select Text with Similar Formatting. Naturally, that selects all the answers. Now let us change this to Calibri and then change this to the same 24. Now we have got the formatting done as far as the font sizes are concerned. Now I don't want the font color to be in this blue, so let us select everything by pressing Ctrl A and then change the font color to black. Now our job is done as far as the word format is concerned. Now the next step is to use this option called Send to Microsoft PowerPoint. Now, this is an option that is available only in the recent versions of PowerPoint. If you don't have this option, absolutely no worry. You just go ahead and save this file by giving it a name. I'm calling this the Geography Quiz and it is in the desktop and I'm going to say save. Once you save it, you just go ahead and close the file. Now let us go to PowerPoint, say open, go to browse and find the location where you have saved it. At first, you'll only see all these PowerPoint files and that is because you've got this selected, which is all PowerPoint presentations by default. You click on this drop-down menu and say all files. That'll show the remaining file types. We want to select this geography quiz, which is a Word document, and say open. Now, PowerPoint will open the Word document into this format. Now, when I go to slide sorter, you see that most of the work is already done. We have a slide for each of the questions, and inside we have the title, we have the options, and the answer. The next step is to format the slide master for this slide type, so we can apply custom animation and trigger animation for just this single layout, so we can have that applied to all the slides. Let me show you how it is done. You go to the first slide, go to view and say slide master, and you can see that all the slides in the file are using this single layout. So we are going to make changes to this layout. First, I'm going to change the font theme to choose the font for my title and the body content. I'm going to choose this one, which has 2cmt condensed extra bold for the title, and we have Calibri for the body content. Next, I don't really require any of these footers, so I'm going to select that and delete. Then let me select this and move it up slightly so I can create space for my answer. Now let me go to Insert Placeholder, which is still in the Slide Master tab. Select text and then I'm going to create this space here for my answer. I don't need any of these other levels, so select this and delete. And we don't even require a bullet point for this. So let me select this, go to home and say no bullet points. Now let us create the button for the answer. Go to home tab again, go to auto shapes gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and let us create a simple rectangular button and say answer. You can of course change the font type to say 2cmt condensed extra bold and increase the font size. If you want to change the button color, you can do so, have it with no outline. The next step is to apply custom animation. So you select all of this, go to Animations tab and say wipe. And this happens from left and this happens on click. So on a click, each of these options will be revealed. Next, I'm going to select this piece here, apply wipe animation from left. But this time, this animation will only be triggered. So you see this option here called trigger. You click on this, on click off. There is only one rectangle here called rectangle 9. You select that. Only on the click of this button, this will be revealed. Excellent. Now let us go to slide master and close master view. Now you don't see the space here for the answer. That is because the layout still needs to be reset. So let us select this. Press Ctrl A to select all of the slides and then say reset here in the slides group under the home tab. When you click reset, immediately you have this box where you can put your answer. Now go back to the first slide. Now all we need to do is to select this answer, press Ctrl X to cut it, and then select this, press Ctrl V to paste it. Now the answer is put inside this box. We just need to do that for all the other slides as well. Just cut this and paste it over here. It is a very simple operation, so you have all the answers done with a trigger animation. So when you go to slideshow, you will have the question in the title. Then on a click, we will have the first option revealed. Then you keep clicking to reveal all the options. Ask the question, and once the student answers, you click on this button and the answer gets revealed. Then you go to the next slide by just clicking, automatically advances to the next question. Click and reveal each of the options. And once the question is answered, you click here and check if the answer is correct. So even if you have 100 questions in your quiz created in MS Word, it is easy for you to convert it into an interactive animated PowerPoint file in a matter of minutes. Since we are teachers and trainers ourselves, we fully understand your needs, and that is the reason why our PowerPoint Templates Pack for Teachers is such a popular product among teachers. The product is priced reasonably, so all teachers can afford it. And it'll save you a lot of time in creating your PowerPoint presentations and will help you hold the attention of even the most distracted students in your class. So click on the link in the description box below the video, come to this page, check out more details about the product, and you can also take a preview of the different types of animations used in these sample slides. Go through a whole bunch of testimonials taken from teachers across the world. And if you find this to be useful, go ahead and make a purchase, and you will realize that it is one of the best investments you can make for your teaching career. In the meantime, do you want to learn a few useful PowerPoint tips and tricks for teachers that you can use in your next presentation? We have just the right video for you right here. All you need to do is to click on the link and watch the video to pick up tips that will definitely impress your colleagues and your students. So go ahead, click, watch, learn, and impress your students with your PowerPoint presentations.